Hello, I trust that you're doing well. Welcome to Ms. Fountain Channel, your go-to destination for insightful and engaging educational content. Here, we explore a wide range of topics, from science and history to technology and beyond. Prepare to expand your knowledge and spark your curiosity with our carefully crafted videos. Subscribe now and join us on our journey of discovery. In today's session, we're going to look at spatial techniques. That is a nuclear magnetic resonance and infrared spectroscopy. I'm going to begin with a brief introduction. That nuclear magnetic resonance, which is commonly abbreviated as NMR, is a technique for determining the structure of organic. Nuclear magnetic resonance is a phenomenon that occurs when the nuclei of certain atoms are placed in magnetic field and exposed to a second oscillating magnetic field. That is, the magnetic component of electromagnetic radiation, which is abbreviated as EMR. Some nuclei experience this phenomenon and others do not, depending upon whether they process a property called spin. The spin of a proton causes an NMR signal. When electromagnetic radiation is used to bombard the hydrogen atoms present, will absorb photons of different energies depending upon the location of the hydrogen atom. For instance, in compounds containing hydrogen and chloride, the proton near the chloride atom produces a different nuclear magnetic resonance signal than the proton located near a single hydrogen. The energy absorbed by the spinning nuclei can be plotted versus the frequency of the applied electromagnetic radiation to obtain a nuclear magnetic resonance spectrum of the molecules. Magnetic properties are only exhibited by molecules that have atoms with an odd mass number. Nuclei with an equal number of protons and neutrons will have an even distribution of charge. An imbalance will give the atom a magnetic moment. That is, it will be positively charged section in a negatively charged section. Under normal conditions, there will be no preferred orientation. But if the molecule is placed in a magnetic field, it will tend to occupy a position involving the least energy, and will, like a compass needle, align itself with the magnetic field. In most cases, the only possible orientations is against or aligned the magnetic field. The transmission between these two orientations, which is due to electric field effect, will require a specific quantum of energy, which can be provided by the magnetic aspect of electromagnetic radiation in a comparable manner to absorption in the UV region of the spectrum. Also, the energy is provided in the radio wave region of the spectrum with wavelength in the meters corresponding to frequencies of megahertz. A nucleus with its magnetic moment aligned with a magnetic field is said to show parallel alignment, while the higher energy state is said to be antiparallel. Here we have an NMR instrumentation. The technique of NMR involve placing the sample in a magnetic field generated between the poles of either a permanent magnet or an electromagnet made from coils. From my image, you can see the magnetic pole. We have two magnetic poles. We have the sweep coils. You can see the radio frequency transmitter. You have the sweep net. We have radio frequency receiver and amplifier. And you also have the control and console recorder. The energy of transition is produced by a radio frequency generator, and the strength of the signal is measured by the receiver. The detection of radio signals in modern instruments involve the same probe or antennae is used both as transmitter and as a receiver, with very rapid changes from a function to another. The energy required to cause a transition depends on the molecular features of the test substance, but also on the strength of the magnetic field. It has to be overcome during the transition. And if NMR was directly compared to UVV spectroscopy, the absorption characteristics would be monitored as the radio frequency was increased. However, in practice, because of technical difficulties in the generation and detection of a signal of varying frequency, the frequency is held constant and the magnetic field is changed. The absorption is monitored. Have the Fourier. We have the image of a Fourier transform, NMR. Before we get to that, the magnets have a constant magnetic field, and the variation required is introduced by coils mounted on the probe face or on the probe faces of the magnets. The current provided to the coils provides the basis of the x-axis of the resulting spectrum, that is the comparable to wavelength in UVB absorption spectrum. All magnets show some variation in the magnetic field across the face of the magnet, and in order to average the effects of these differences, the sample is rotated rapidly in the magnetic field. In modern NMR instruments, use the Fourier system, where the NMR scan is based, or is basically a series of pulses and delays. Now, Fourier transform NMR system. In this image, you can see you have the south and north, creating the magnetic field. We have the RF transmitter. Have the pulse switch, frequencies in the synthesizer. We have the RF amplifier. We have the phase sensitive detector. You can see time swept computer and Fourier transform. You also have the output. In this, as a short pulse of radiation is applied to the sample and the magnetic field is scanned. And if the signal due to water is suppressed, there is initial saturation at the water frequency, which is diminished by addition of deuterium oxide. Before another test can be taken, the sample must be allowed to relax, and during this period, further saturation of the water signal can be done, and the process repeated many times. The sequence of events and collection of data and the generation operation of NMR spectrometer is automated. That's the end of our session. Thank you for joining us. We hope you've gained valuable insights and knowledge from today's video. Remember to like, to subscribe, to share, to comment. And stay tuned for more enlightening content. And remember, learning never stops. Until next time, stay curious and keep exploring.